Hari Om.
We shall chant from verse number 36. Arjuna vacha stane rishikesha tava prakirtya jagat prahrushyatyanurajyate cha rakshansi bhitani disho dravanti sarve namasyanti cha siddha sanghah kasmachate na nameran mahatman gariyase brahmanopyadikartre ananta devesh jagannivasa tvamaksharam sadasat tatparam yat tvamadi deva purusha puranah tvamasya vishvasya param nidhanam vetasi vidyancha parancha dhamam tvaya tatam vishvam anantarupa vayuryamognir varunah shashankah prajapatistvam prapitamahascha namo namaste stu sahasrakritvah punascha bhuyopi namo namaste nama purastadatha prishthataste namostu te sarvata eva sarva ananta viryamita vikramastvam sarvam samapnoshi tatosi sarvah. So here we have a beautiful prayer by Arjuna addressed to Bhagavan in his Vishwarup. It's the most beautiful and most universal prayer, wherein in the beginning of this prayer Arjuna is expressing the mahima of Bhagavan, that everything is tane, stane rishikesha tava prakirtya jagat pravrushyatyanurajyate cha, that it is appropriate the people rejoice in you, they do namaskar to you. Everything is stane, they praise you. And why not? Because you are the beginning and even the creator of Brahmaji. You are infinite, the very abode of the entire world. From you only, the world which is made up of Sat and Asat is born. You are the Adi Deva, most ancient, the abode of this world, and you alone are the knower in all, and you are the ultimate tattva to be known, and you are the ultimate our destination, param cha dhama. You yourself are all the devatas, vayu, yama, agni, varuna, shashanka, prajapatis, tvam, prapitamahascha. Namaskar to you, thousands of namaskar to you, and again namaskar to you. Namaskar from the front, namaskar from the back, namaskar from all the side to you who is everything and who pervades everything, who is of tremendous infinite power and prowess, ananta viryam Virya Amita Vikramastvam Sarvam Samapnoshi Tatosi Sarvaha. So Arjuna is seeing the direct glory of Bhagavan. This is not something which he has read in the scriptures or understood, but directly experiencing Ishvara as the Vishwarup. And as he is experiencing, he is describing. And when he saw Bhagavan's might and power and that everything is him and he is so very supreme, again that thought came to Arjuna's mind that he is with us as Krishna. He is playing with us, he is all the time with us, he is interacting, we are interacting with him. And then he realized that without knowing his greatness, that we have been treating, or I have been treating him just like my equal, like my friend. So that thought when it came to his mind, he is expressing here some very beautiful shloka, shloka number 41. Sakheti matva prasabham yaduktam. He Krishna he Yadava he Sakheti. Ajanata mahimanam tavedam. Maya pramadat pranayena vapi. Sakheti matva prasabham yaduktam. He says that sakheti matva prasabham yaduktam, that I considered you as my sakha, as equal. Sakha means one who is equal, our friend, who we don't have, we don't show special reverence or something to a friend, nor does we insult, we're equal, we consider equal, we have saman khyati, same fame life. So when you see two friends, one of them if you see, you ask about the other also. They are known together. Arjuna and Krishna were known together, like Krishna Arjuna we say. So he says that I did not know your glory and I treated you just as an ordinary person, as my friend. Sakheti matva prasabham yaduktam, and out of ignorance, out of not knowing your glory, not knowing that you are that great, this Vishwarup, Ishvara himself, not knowing this, I have just casually addressed you also, just like an ordinary our friend, saying that, hey Krishna, calling you by first name and all like that. Hey Krishna. Hey Krishna. Hey Yadava. Sometimes I addressed you as Yadava because he was born in that Yaduvamsha. So, hey Yadava. Hey Sakheti, or hey friend. Oh my buddy, high five, like that, I just treated you as my equal without knowing your greatness. See, lot of things actually we are unaware, and about people, about places, about some objects also. Even ordinary water actually, if you just somebody gives you water, you will drink. But someone tells you this, I brought specially this water from Manas Sarovar for you. I walked all the way, so much of trouble, and took a dip. After taking dip, after chanting Bhagavan's name, I picked up this water. And please take one little drop. So when we take it, we will take with lot of reverence. We will not just casually take it, because we know the mahima of that. Similarly, here Arjuna recognized the mahima. Before that he did not know. He was treating him just like his ordinary friend. So very sweetly he is expressing, Sakheti matva prasabham yaduktam. and that is Bhagavan's greatness as avatar. He comes down to a level, he teaches us dharma. As Krishna, he became the charioteer of Arjuna's. In the war, he became the charioteer. And he did all the duties of a charioteer. He used to get up early, prepare the chariot before the war began, take care of the horses. Then after the war also, again take care of the horses, feed them, give them water. If they are injured, then malampatti vagare, all those things he used to do. Just like an ordinary charioteer, he became a charioteer for Arjuna. So he suddenly realized how Sakshat Ishvara, he has given me so much of importance, and I did not even realize his greatness. He says, Sakheti Matva Prasabham, out of ignorance, not knowing, Yaduktam, I just spoke to you just casually, Hey Krishna, Hey Yadava, Hey Sakheti, Ajanata Mahimanam Tavedam, this Idam Mahima, this wonderful glory of yours, that in you everything exists. All the devatas whom we worship, all the great Rishi Munis whom we revere so much, and the great worlds which we want to go and attain, Swargalok and Brahmalok and Sakshat Brahmaji also, all of them exist in you. All of them are born in you. You are their source, and everything merged back into you. Even when they are not there, you exist. They cannot exist without you, but you can exist without them. That is the power. That is the great reality. Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma. Even the Vedas, they fail to comprehend that supreme. Even the Vedas, finally, after speaking a lot, finally Vedas also say, na iti, neti, 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 neti. Not this much, this much more. Even after talking about that supreme for years together, still we will not be able to express all its glories. So, not knowing that Mahima, I just did not know that with whom I am interacting. So, Ajanata Mahimanam, just imagine that feeling which Arjuna must have had in his heart. So, it happens even in the world with ordinary person and all. You are just casually, you are sitting with someone and then suddenly you realize that is a very famous and important person. It is said about Mahatma Gandhi also. He was traveling by train and someone just spat on the, what you call that, window, but it fell inside only. So Mahatma Gandhi picked up on paper, he just wiped it and threw it out. So he was quite irritated, he gone here, thinking himself to be very special or smart and all. So he did not appreciate it, but later on the station came and lots of people came to receive him with malas and this and that, and suddenly he realized that I was sitting with a great Mahatma. I thought he was the ordinary person. Similarly here, Arjuna thought that Krishna was just though special, he had special knowledge, special abilities, but just a human being. But now he realizes he is Sakshat Ishvara only, who is there. Ajanata Mahimanam Tavedam Maya Pramadat. Out of Pramad, out of forgetfulness, out of not knowing properly, out of just affection, casual affection towards you, just like we show affection to our friend and all, I have spoken to you in a very, not with so much reverence which is required. Without that proper reverence, I just spoke to you. So he is feeling very, very bad about it. So, maya pramadat pranayena vapi. He is expressing more in the next verse. He is saying, Yachcha vaha sarthama satkrutosi viharashayasana bhojaneshu ekota vapyachyuta tatkshamaksham tatkshamaksham takshamaye tvamaham aprameyam yachcha vaha sarthama satkrutosi viharasaya takshamaye tvamaham aprameyam yachcha avaha sartham asatkrutosi, just for the sake of fun, just like we make fun of our friends and all, some practical joke, some fun, what you call majak karte hai, upahas, wherein there is, we don't show proper reverence, proper respect, just do some practical joke, like that I have done with you also, hey Krishna, oh Bhagwan, I have done with you, I might have insulted you or not respected you properly. It happens actually, you don't show special reverence or this for not knowing. Yachcha vaha sartham asat krutosi vihara shayya asana bhojaneshu, in this various thing, vihara while just walking, strolling toward in the garden or something, or just vihar na, kya bolte usko, walking, strolling. So you make fun, you do all sorts of things, you must have done. I don't have to describe all the fun things which we do with our friends. Sometimes we hide also, and that fellow is talking and we suddenly hide behind, or do all sorts of things, or write something behind his back. I mean, I don't want to give you ideas, but we do a lot of fun things with our friends. We don't think it is an insult, because that friend also does, and it's like a just majak, like for joy. But here he says that you are Sakshat Ishwar, and you accepted all that we did without even getting angry or something. So vihara, then shayya, sometimes sleeping together, we make fun. Sometimes people snore and all at night, and people take their videos also and make them listen. Because many people, they say that, oh no, I never snore. उनका वो पूरा वो बता देते हैं कि ये दिस साउंड विच यू हियर इज दो द रॉकेट इज टेकिंग ऑफ इज एक्चुअली यू आर स्नोरिंग. सो विहार शैया वाइल स्लीपिंग एंड ऑल समटाइम पिलो फाइट एंड ऑल दोज थिंग्स. सो विहार शैया आसन और वाइल जस्ट सिटिंग कैजुअली सिटिंग चैटिंग. That time also I must have made fun of you, or not expressed proper reverence or respect to you, thinking that you are just my friend, don't have to treat you in some special way. So asana bhojaneshu, at times during bhojan also, even there is, if Bhagwan, like we are doing puja and all, before eating we offer it to Bhagwan only, the naivedya, we don't eat before that, we offer properly with proper reverence. But a friend, we can just casually, we eat before or we together, or we can just make fun even while eating. So I must have done this, I must have disrespected you, not intentionally, but just as a friend, disrespected you just for fun during that vihara shayya asana bhojaneshu, sometimes alone, ekaha, sometimes when we were alone, nobody else was there, just you and me, and I made some fun of you. or athava api achyuta, or sometimes in front of others also, or behind your back. Sometimes we make fun of a person behind their back also. That person came back after the party and all, so the husband asked her that what happened, you are not looking very happy. She said, we have these 50 members and all 50 members came today, so there was no fun. So when somebody is absent, you can talk and this and that and mazak karo, or you can tell all sorts of lies also about that person and enjoy. So sometimes we make fun of people behind their back. Sometimes we make fun in front of everyone, or sometimes alone. So he says, ekaha athava api achyuta tat samaksham, right in front of you or behind your back. So tat kshamaye, please forgive me for all this. Please forgive me. See this, as I said, this is also universal prayer for everyone. We also knowingly, unknowingly are constantly doing aparad towards Bhagavan only. Bhagavan Shankaracharya ji, he has written a very beautiful stotra, Shiva Aparada Kshamapana Stotram, wherein he says that right from our birth till our death, we commit so many sins and so much aparad towards Ishvara. And one of the greatest aparad is to forget him. He has given us everything. He has given us birth. He has given all the opportunity. We forget. When we are in mother's womb, we forget. When we are born, we are busy eating, drinking and crying and all, and we forget. As we grow, we are busy in all sorts of pleasures and we forget Bhagavan. Then we are busy trying to make our career and all, and we forget. Then we get married and children and take them to the school and all, and PTA meeting, and we forget. Then we retire and all, and then again some days we forget. Even after retirement we have to do some babysitting and all, and we forget. So in this way, balastavat chintasta, balastavat krida saktah, tarunastavat taruni saktah, vriddhastavat chinta saktah, parame brahmani kopi na saktah. Bhagavan Shankaracharya ji says in Bhaja Govindam that as little children we are busy playing, as youngsters we are busy in our various types of pleasures, and as elders we are busy worrying about everything. We worry about ourselves, we worry about our family, we worry about the society, we worry about our culture also. Aajkal pata nahi kya ho raha hai, hamare zamane mein aisa nahi tha. So we worry about everything. Then we worry about God also. Pata nahi Bhagwan ko kya lagta hoga. Ki ye jagat kyun banaya? So we worry, chinta. But parame brahmani ko pi na sakta. But nobody is paying attention or meditating or praying to that Ishvara. Nobody has got time for him. So our time just goes by. So we commit lot of mistakes or aparadha against Bhagavan, for which we should ask for forgiveness constantly. So in our prayer, there should be a portion of forgiveness also. Ki karacharana kritam va, kayajam karmajam va, shravana nayanajam va, manasam va paradam, vihitam avihitam va, sarvameta kshamasva, jai jai karunabdhe shri mahadeva shambho. That whatever aparad I have done, knowingly, unknowingly, with my body, speech, indriyas, mind, with my swabhav, whatever aparad I have done, please forgive me. So here also Arjuna is remembering, and we are doing this aparad. We actually get lot of things from Bhagavan and we don't acknowledge it. That's also an aparad. Constantly complain instead of saying thank you. It's aparad only. So takshamaye twamaham, please forgive me. Arjuna is saying, please forgive me. I didn't do this intentionally. I did not know your glory and your Mahima. I did not know that you are present in everything and everyone. That if I am insulting someone, indirectly I am insulting you. If I am hurting someone, I am hurting you. If I am disregarding someone, I am disregarding you, because you are present everywhere in everyone. So please forgive me. Kshamaye Tvam Aham Aprameyam. You are that Aprameya, difficult to comprehend. With all our pramanas, means of knowledge, it's not possible to comprehend the greatness of Ishvara. Our buddhi is too small to understand the vast glories of Bhagavan. It's not possible. So he is aprameya, beyond all pramanas. So tvam aham aprameyam takshamaye. Please forgive me. So he is asking for forgiveness. Now in the next verse he is giving an example how he expect Bhagavan to forgive him. He says, Pitasi lokasya characharasya tvamasya pujyascha gurur gariyam natvat samostyabhyadikakkutonyah lokatrayepya pratima prabhava pitasi lokasya characharasya he says that you are the father of this whole world. Pitasi lokasya, you are the father. In the 9th chapter also, Bhagavan himself said that I am the father. Pitahamasya jagataha mata dhata pitamaha. I am the father of this world. Then who is the mother? He says, I myself am the mother of this world. But who is our grandfather then? He says, I myself am the grandfather also. And here he had said that I am great-grandfather also myself. I mean, there is no other cause for this world than that Ishvara, who is Satyam Jnanam Anantam, pure existence, consciousness, bliss. So, Pitasi Lokasya Characharasya, and what is this Loka, what is this world? Both made up of sentient and insentient, chara, which moves, achara, which doesn't move, all sentient and insentient beings and objects, Bhagavan is the Pita, he is the source, from him only everything has come. He is both the Upadan Karan as well as what? Nimitta Karan, Abhinna Upadana Nimitta Karan. So both the material cause as well as the efficient cause. So pitasi lokasya characharasya tvam asya, you are of this world. Also pujyaha, you are the most worshipful. You are the most worshipful. Through each and every, even the devatas, other devatas we worship, through them we should worship that Ishvara only. If we worship the devata thinking that they are little devata, then it is worship of those devata. But if we see through them that only Ishvara is functioning through them and worship that Ishvara, then even through that little devata we are worshipping Ishvara only. It's like our cloth, like our ordinary cloth you use and all. But when we have that tricolor, and we use it as a flag and salute it, it represents the entire country, and we are saluting that flag, we are respecting the country. Otherwise it's just a flag. Similarly, one ordinary what you call stone, we can invoke the presence of Ishvara and worship. We can invoke the presence of Ishvara in the devatas, in the trees, in the mountains, in the rivers, in everyone, in the human beings, in animals, birds, plants. We can invoke the presence. we can see the presence of Ishvara in everyone. Ishvara is present in everyone. But one object, one person is not present in everyone. A jiva is not present in everyone. But Ishvara is present in all the jivas. So we can worship even a jiva as Ishvara, invoking the presence of Ishvara even in an ordinary jiva. So pita asi lokasya characharasya tvam asya pujyah. You are most worshipful, pujyah. Why? Because gurur gariyan, you are the most supreme, you are the supreme most. You are the guru, you are also the teacher, the most, what you call, supreme teacher, and most, what you call, above everyone. Gurur gariyan, above everyone. So, natvat samaha asti, there is nobody equal to you. See here, Shankaracharya ji has written very interestingly that there cannot be two Ishvara or more than one Ishvara. He says, Nahi Ishvara dvayam sambhavati aneka Ishvaratve vyavahara anupapattehe. He says, there cannot be two Ishvara or more than two also, four or five Ishvaras. Ishvara means master. If there is even two Ishvara, the world will not function, he says, because both of them will have different ideas. One will say, chalo, samhar karte hai. Another Ishvara say, nahi, nahi, thodi der aur rukte hai. One Ishvara will say, let us give him this karma faladata. Others will, no, he is my special favorite, you give him more. Let us give him more. So there will be conflict. There cannot be two heads, two gods, not possible. Three gods, four gods. Jivas are many, God is only one. Even what we call God, Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh, and all the devatas and all, they are gods, they are jivas only. They are given the status of God. They have certain responsibility. They have certain position. And they have their own time span. Even Brahmaji, after 100 years of Brahmaji, he finishes his life. Then he merges with that Brahma. And another jiva becomes Brahmaji. So even Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh, all of them, they have their own lifespan. But what we call Ishvara is beyond all this. Beyond all these devatas also. He is neither born, nor does he die. He is eternal. Everyone merges into him. That Ishvara. He is the Pujyah. So there is, cannot be two Ishvaras because there will be conflict. Whom to, if they have difference of opinion or difference of ideas, then whose idea should be followed? So it is not possible. Vyavhar will not be there. So there is only one. He said, Tvat sama eva tavat anyo na sambhavati. He said, there is nobody equal to you. What to talk about someone greater than you? There is nobody other than you. Matta parataram nanyat kinchid asti dhananjaya. In 7th chapter also Bhagavan says, there is nobody other than me, higher than me, lower than me. Nobody is there. I alone am there. So na tvat samaha asti. Abhya adikaha kuta. What to talk about greater or anyaha or different. Lokatrayepi, in all the three worlds, there is nothing other than Bhagavan. He is apratima prabhava. Unka prabhav jo hai, apratima. Apratima means there is no comparison. There is no object or anything which we can say that, oh, this is like Ishvara. Pratimiyate yaya sa pratima. Na vidyate pratima yasya tava prabhavasya sa tvam apratima prabhavah. Unki koi pratima nahi hai. We cannot have an image of Bhagavan, he is like this or like that and all. What image we keep is for our help, but he is not restrained into that image. is not limited to that image. It's for our own sadhana. So we take shaligram, we take shivalinga, we worship. But slowly as our mind becomes pure, we can directly meditate on that nirgun nirakar brahma. So pitasi lokasya characharasya tvamasya pujyascha gurur gariyan natvat samaha asti abhyakaha kutaha anyaha lokatrepi apratima prabhava. Aapka prabhav, aapka that your power is beyond all comparison. Therefore, please, I have whatever aparad I have done, please forgive me. How should you forgive? Actually, in this verse now, Arjuna is expressing that. He is saying, tasmat pranamya pranidhaya kayam prasadaye tvamaham ishamidyam piteva putrasya sakheva sakhyuhu priya priya yarhasi deva sodhum tasmat pranamya pranidhaya kayam. Tasmat, therefore, pranamya, I am doing namaskar to you. Pranidhaya kayam, by just falling at your feet, by bringing my even body down, bowing down to you, bringing my body down on the ground, I am doing namaskar to you with all humility. So, tasmat pranamya pranidhaya kayam. Prasadaye tvam, I am pleasing you. I am worshipping you to please you. Tvam aham isham, you are isham, you are the master. You are the great master of this whole cosmos and most worshipful, most praiseworthy, idyam, most praiseworthy. And Isham, you are the master. Without you, nothing happens. Everyone follows your laws, your rules. See, many times people, they say, oh, no, you don't have to believe in God. Everything is laws of nature. It's not laws of nature, it's laws of God. This nature belongs to God. Prakriti, what we say, is Bhagwan's Prakriti. It is not just Prakriti hanging. It is a adjective actually. Kiska hai? Bhagwan ka hai. Suppose somebody says, is beautiful, huh? Beautiful. Tom, kaun beautiful? What is beautiful? No. Beautiful. Who is beautiful? Similarly, when we say nature, whose nature? Ishvara's nature. Nature is not just something hanging in the air. So what we call the world is Ishvara's nature, his Prakriti. He says, my Prakriti. So all the laws and rules which are there, they are Bhagwan's laws and rules. So please, you are the most worshipful, you are the master. I am doing namaskar to you, please, to please you. Please forgive me. How should you forgive? Piteva putrasya, just like a father forgives the son, whatever, in Kali Yuga actually that also doesn't happen, but generally, 99%, the son does all sorts of gadbadi, that and all, and father forgives, right? Sometimes says something wrong, sometimes does something wrong. Sometimes treats a person wrongly. And nowadays in people have this all sorts of things. Sometimes children, they expect much more from their parents. If they don't do, then they get annoyed. Even little children, if you don't celebrate the birthday properly, they think the parents don't love them. So all sorts of crazy things are there. And from the size of their gift and size of the cake, they know, my parents love me. How do you know? Itna bada cake laya tha mere liye. Last year they did not love me because it was 2 inches less. Then they spit on it and cut it and distribute. So we expect, children start expecting, and parents also sometimes say, Baba, you do your, lead your life yourself. We don't want anything from you. At least you lead your life yourself. Anyway, so even when the children and all behave in whatever way, the parents forgive. The father forgives the son. So similarly here Arjuna is saying, you just treat me as your son, someone who has committed some mistakes and apradh, please forgive me as my father. Piteva putrasya sakheva sakhyuhu, or like a friend forgives a friend. See, among friends also a lot of things happen, and one should have that sense of that forgiveness, because everyone is not perfect and mistakes keep happening. And many times what happens actually, instead of remembering all the good things which our friend, our parents did, we remember one bad thing also. Us din aapne aisa kaha. Now no more friendship. I am giving up my friendship with you. Some children and all, they just give up their house also now. I have disowned my parents now. They said this, like this, in front of all my friends. So just as sakha, sakheva sakyuhu, like a friend forgives the friend. See, the friendship is something quite interesting. All other relationship, some blood relationship and all, and friendship is totally different. In the 12th chapter we will see, Bhagavan is telling that a bhakta, who is the a bhakta, one of the lakshana of bhakta, he says, one who is friendly towards everyone. Adveshta sarvabhutana maitraha, maitraha sarvabhutana. One who is, has got that attitude of friendship towards everyone. Everyone means towards nature, towards animals, birds, plants, everyone. We can make friendship with everyone. It's possible. So, there is no that way blood relationship, but it's a very beautiful relationship. Therefore, one of the relationship which we can have towards Bhagavan also is of friendship. Sakya Bhakti it is called. Like Arjuna had towards Bhagavan Krishna, actually, there was like Sakya Bhakti he had. So friends, they forgive each other. And that should be there in to keep the relationship healthy and going. Some give and take happens, sometimes mistake happens, we have to just forgive, forget and move ahead. So sakheva sakhyuhu, or priya priya yarhasi, or like a beloved and a lover, lover and beloved. Like two lovers are there, they have their relationship. And among them also sometimes mistakes happen, someone says something bad or does something wrong. We should have a large heart to forgive also. And they do, when there is great love, they forgive also. So just as a lover forgives his beloved, and like a friend forgives his friend, like a father forgives his son, hey Bhagavan, you should also forgive me, Priya. Arhasi deva sodhum, whatever aparad I have done, please forgive me. And this should be our sadhana, our prayer actually. Nobody is perfect, and as long as till we reach that state of enlightenment, some mistake or other aparad keeps happening. We commit aparad towards our own parents, elders, towards nature, towards gods, towards rishis, towards our ancestors. By not following what our ancestor, the tradition, culture or the dharma of our family, when we don't follow, we are insulting our ancestors. Because some of the things which we got in our family has come from all the way from great rishis. Therefore we say that we are from this gotra and all, Bharadwaj gotra. So there are certain things which we have learnt, our forefathers have learnt from Bharadwaj rishi, and it has come down till us, and suddenly we, out of our own ignorance, we say, I don't want to follow this custom and all. I am a modern educated person, I am a scientist, and I have studied everything, and there is no God, what God and all. So they break the tradition, they insult ancestors. So we should not do like that. We should continue the tradition. Then our scriptures. Scriptures have also come to us from the great rishis. By studying the scriptures, by constantly chanting the mantras and stotras which they have given to us, we are fulfilling our debt to them, repaying to them. So if we don't do, then we are doing aparad. If we don't worship the devatas regularly, we are doing aparad. If we don't treat our parents and elders properly, we are doing aparad. If we are not treating the nature properly, birds, animals, plants and nature, then we are doing aparad. So we should not do this aparad. And for all the aparad we have done in the past, we should ask for forgiveness from Bhagwan, because indirectly we are hurting him only. So same thing here, Arjuna is asking for forgiveness from Bhagwan. So piteva putrasya sakheva sakhyuhu priya priya yarhasi deva sodhum. Further, now he is saying, adrishta purvam hrishitoshmi drishtva bhayena cha pravyathitam manome tadeva me darshaya devarupam prasida devesha jagannivasa adrishta purvam hrishitosmi drishtva bhayena cha adrishtapurvam hrishitoshmi drishtva. Bhagavan Arjuna says, having seen this, your Vishwarup, and how is that Vishwarup? Adrishtapurvam, nobody has seen this before. It was never seen by me nor by anyone else, such unseen and most miraculous sight or darshan Arjuna had, by Bhagavan's grace only. By our effort, we cannot see this Vishwarup. So, adrishta purvam hrishitosmi drishtva, and I am very, very happy seeing this. I am feeling honored that you showed me this Vishwarup. See, so many other people were there, but Bhagavan chose Arjuna, and he gave him and showed him this Vishwarup. So, Arjuna is feeling very, very pleased. Harsha unko ho raha hai. Adrishtapurvam hrishitoshvi drishtva. But at the same time he is saying that bhayena cha pravyathitam manome, because this Vishwarup was not very pleasant also. He could see the entire war and millions of people dying, and great warriors were getting crushed in Bhagwan's mouth. They were entering in the bhayanak drishya, that he got frightened. He said, bhayena pravyathitam manome, my mind is getting agitated out of fear. So he is now requesting, after seeing this Vishwarup, now Arjuna is requesting, ki tadeva me darshayat deva rupam, that please show me your original form now. Show me your previous simple Krishna form. I have seen this Vishwarup. I am very satisfied, happy, but filled with fear also. So please come back to your Krishna form. So tadeva me darshaya deva rupam. And he is requesting prasida, that please be pleased with me. Mujhe prasad de dijiye. Prasad means that purity of our heart. See, when we do puja, when we do this prarthana, we ask, what do we ask? What should we ask? We should ask for prasad only. Prasad khao. Prasad means not to eat. Prasad means purity of our mind. Prasad means that unconditional joy which we feel in our heart. Prasad means when we feel that sense of total security that Bhagavan has blessed me. He is with us. That we don't have to be afraid of anything. That He is pleased with us. That type of attitude when it comes in our heart is called prasad. Prasid. Please be pleased with me. That is the prayer Arjuna is, what he is asking. He is asking for this prasad. That you be pleased and may I get this purity of my heart and the joy, unconditional joy in my heart. So prasida devesha, O devesha, O the lord of all the devatas, jagannivasaha, the very abode of the entire world, please bless me, be pleased with me, give me that joy, unconditional joy and that purity of my heart, and please again show me your original, that previous form. Tadeva me darshaya deva rupam. Which form you want to see? So he says in the next verse, kiritinam gadinam chakrahastam. Ichchami tvam drashtum aham tathaiva. Tenaiva rupena chaturbhujena. Sahasrabaho bhava vishvamurte. Kiritinam gadinam chakrahastam. Ichchami tvam drashtum aham tathaiva tenaiva rupena chaturbhuji. Here Arjuna is requesting Bhagavan to show him that chaturbhuja roop with which he had come in as Vasudev's son. So first Bhagavan actually appeared in front of Vasudev as the chaturbhuja, with Shankh Chakra Gada Padma Dhari as Vishnu. He appeared in front of Vasudev and Devaki, and thereafter then he took the form of little Krishna. So here Arjuna is requesting both. First he wants to see Bhagavan in that Chaturbhuja form, and thereafter he wants him to be as Krishna, as him whom he always knew as his sakha. So kiritinam, wearing a crown, gadinam, with gada in his hand, mace, then chakra hastam, with a chakra, sudarshan chakra. So chakra hastam, ichchami tvam drashtum aham tatheva, I want to see you in that form. Ichchami tvam, that is more calm, peaceful, more acceptable, like I will be able to quieten my mind seeing that form. So I want to see that form of yours. Ichchami tvam drashtum aham tathaiva tenaiva rupena chaturbhujena. In that roop, with chaturbhuja, with four arms, shankh chakra gada padmadhari, with four arms as Bhagavan Vishnu, that roop, that form I want to see. Tenaiva rupena chaturbhujena. Hey sahasrabaho, now you are sahasrabaho, you have infinite hands, thousands of hands you have, everyone's hands belongs to you, but now you reduce the number of hands and four hands. Chaturbhujena. See, it might be that even Bhagavan Krishna might be, what you call, now and then appearing in his four arms, or he must be referring to that Bhagavan's form as Vishnu only. So, Chaturbhujena Sahasrabaho Bhava Vishwamurte, O Vishwamurte, O Sahasrabaho, O Bhagavan with thousands of arms, you come in front of us, me now, with your four-armed form. So, Tena Eva Rupena Chaturbhujena, please. See, he is requesting. So, he saw, Arjuna saw the beautiful form. He praised Bhagavan, he expressed his glory, then he asked, he expressed what aparadh he did, then he asked for forgiveness, and he asked for prasad also, that may you be pleased with me. And then he is again requesting, you've come in front of me with your chaturbhuja form, and as you were before. So after listening to this, Arjuna, Bhagavan immediately, he comes in that chaturbhuj form, and then again as Krishna, he says, Shri Bhagavan Uvacha, Maya Prasannena Tavarjunedam, Rupam Param Darshitam Atma Yoga, Tejo Mayam Vishvam Anantamadhyam Yanme Tvadanyena Natrashtu Purvam Maya Prasannena Tavarjunedam Rupam Param Darshitam Atma Yogat. Shri Bhagavan Vacha. Bhagavan, Arjunam Bhitam Upalabhya Upasamritya Vishwarupam Priyavachanena Ashvasayan. Shankaracharya ji writes that he withdrew his Vishwarup and now he is speaking to Arjuna. He is saying that Maya Prasannena Tava Arjuna Idam Rupam Param Darshitam Atma Yogat. He Arjuna, that out of my joy and out of my grace and blessings, you have seen my this Vishwarup. Maya Prasannena Tava Arjuna Idam Rupam Param Darshitam. You have seen my this Param Rupam, this great form of mine, out of my own blessing and grace, and I showed you with the help of my Shakti Atma Yogat. Ishvara has got that power to appear in a small form, to appear as this whole cosmos, or in a small place to show the entire world also to anyone who wants to see. So all this power is there. That power is called yoga. Yoga Shakti. So Darshitam Atma Yogat Tejo Mayam. This my form was filled with all teja, with brilliance. That brilliant form you saw, Vishvam Anantam. This entire Vishva is my form. This infinite cosmos as my form. See, as I said, it's not possible to see this vast world. It's so very vast. Very, 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 very vast. And our scriptures, they talk about Ananta Koti Brahmanda also. Whole world is called Brahmanda. It's like anda. Brahmanda. But there are, not only there is one world, but they talk about sometimes Ananta Koti Brahmanda. And Ishvara is indicated as Ananta Koti Brahmanda Nayaka, the master of infinite worlds. And every world has got Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh. Every world. has got so many devatas and so many beings and all. And who is the master of all of them? That Ishvara. So Tejo Mayam Vishvam Anantam Adyam, who is the very beginning of everything, who is the very source. Yan me tvad annena na drashtu purvam, that my this form nobody has seen before you. I have shown you out of my own love and grace. Other than you, nobody has seen this particular form of mine. Yan me tvad annena na drashtu purvam. And it is not possible also to see this form without my grace. He says in the next verse, Bhagavan says, Na veda yajna adhya nair na danaihi Na chakriya bhir na tapo bhir ugraihi Evam rupa shakya aham nriloke Drashtum tvadanyena kuru pravira Na veda yajna adhya nair na danaihi Bhagavan says, na veda yajna adhyanaihi evam rupam shakyaham aham nriloke. In this world, to see this form is not possible even if you do various types of sadhana. Like the sadhana of doing adhyan of the Vedas or adhyan of the yajnas or performing various types of yajnas, you will not be able to see this form of mine. Or if suppose somebody does the sadhana of dana, lots of charity and all, not possible. Na kriya bihi, or some do different types of rituals, some kriyas, some what you call like agnihotradi, karma, with that also it's not possible. Even if you do lots of tapas, because with tapas we can get anything, but even with tapas you can't see my this form. So tapo bihi ugraihi, even with ugra tapas, you will not be able to see this form of mine. Evam rupa shakya aham nriloke. It is not possible in this world to see this form. Drashtum tvad annena kuru pravira. To see whether by you or by anybody else, it is not possible to see this form of mine. He kuru pravira. Oh, best among the Kauravas, that nobody can see me in this form. Out of my own compassion I showed you, and you don't have to get frightened. Finally he says, Ma te vyatha ma cha vimodha bhavah drishtva rupam ghoram idrum mamedam Vyapetabhi pritamana punastvam Tadeva me rupamidam paprapasya Ma te vyathama cha vimudha bhavah Drishtva rupam ghoramidram mamedam Mathe vyatha, don't get agitated. Macha vimodha bhavaha, don't get confused and deluded seeing this form after seeing my form. Don't get agitated or deluded. Drishtva rupam ghoram idrum mamedam, after seeing this ghore, a very terrible form of mine, you don't have to get frightened and don't have to get disturbed. Vapeta bhihi, give up all your fear. Prita manaha, bring that joy in your heart. punastvam tadeva me ropamidam prapashya. Now again you see my original form. Punaha tvam ropamidam prapashya. So he again, Bhagavan showed him. First Bhagavan showed Arjuna the Chaturbhuja form, and then he again came back to his Krishna form as Krishna. So this now Sanjaya describes. We will read one more shloka. Sanjaya vacha ityarjunam vasudevas tathoktva svakam rupam darshayamasa bhuyah ashvasayamasa cha bhitamenam bhutva punas saumya vapur mahatma ityarjunam vasudevas tathoktva svakam rupam darshayamasa bhuyah. Sanjaya vacha. Sanjaya is telling now Dhritarashtra ki iti arjunam vasudevah tatha uktva. To Arjuna, Bhagavan Vasudev, one who was born the family of Vasudev and Devaki, therefore he is called Vasudev. Vasudev also means actually one who resides in everyone's heart. But here Vasudev means the son of Vasudev and Devaki. So having spoken to Arjuna in this way, Vasudev tatha uktva svakam rupam darshayamasa bhuyah, he showed Arjuna his other form, Chaturbhuj form. The four arms and Shankha Chakra Gada Padmadhari, that rupa also Arjuna could see. And then he gave him lot of ashvasan, lot of solace and all. Ashvasayamasa cha bhitamenam, who was so scared and frightened, Bhagavan gave him some solace, ashvasan. And then he took that saumya vapur, bhutva puna saumya vapur mahatma, then that great mahatma, Bhagavan Krishna, he took the saumya form, the very gentle, nice form as Krishna. Bhutva apana saumya vapur mahatma. So again he became as Krishna. Suddenly all that Vishwaroop and all just disappeared. Again he saw Krishna as he had always seen him, as Krishna sitting in front of him. But now, after the experience of this Vishwaroop, the attitude of Arjuna got totally transformed. Now he is looking at Krishna not as an ordinary person, but he knows he is Sakshat, that Ishvara. He is the Lord of everyone, the resource of this entire cosmos. So after Bhagavan again comes back into his Krishna form, Arjuna, he asks him something, and then Bhagavan replies. That portion is there. So that we will see in our yajna next time. We will begin from here, Arjuna Vacha, complete this, and then we will begin the 12th chapter. Because this 12th chapter is connected to this chapter. The question which Arjuna asks in 12th chapter is very much connected to this chapter. So when we study this, we will be able to comprehend the 12th chapter also properly. So that we will see in our yajna, which will be from 1st of September. Oh. Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.